In this video, I'm going to introduce you to a powerful Marian devotion that will hopefully help to keep you out of mortal sin and obtain the grace of final perseverance. The Three Hail Marys devotion has been promoted by many saints, and it is often promoted and encouraged by traditionally minded priests. This devotion has evolved slightly. When it was first introduced by Saint Mechtild in the 13th century, you would pray this only once a day. You would pray three Hail Marys, one in honor of each of the three persons of the Holy Trinity, and in thanksgiving to them for the various graces that they bestowed upon the Virgin Mary. The promise associated with this devotion at the time was that you would receive spiritual assistance at the hour of your death. Now, the devotion has changed slightly from being about the hour of your death to also being about the avoidance of mortal sin. And this change began with Saint Leonard of Port Maurice and again with Saint Alphonsus Liguori. Now, of all the saints that have promoted this devotion, I give the most weight and attention to Saint Alphonsus, because not only is he a doctor of the church, some call him a doctor of prayer, but he is also the patron saint of moral theologians and confessors. And it is in the confessional that he would encourage people to pray the Three Hail Marys devotion. Now, in Saint Alphonsus's version of this devotion, yes, you would still pray three Hail Marys in honor of the three divine persons of the Holy Trinity, but you would specifically request from Mary that she help to keep you out of mortal sin on that day. Now, he would encourage people to do this in the morning and in the evening. And now you might be saying, Gabriel, you want to add more devotions to my life in the morning and in the evening. Okay, if you can't commit to doing it both in the morning and in the evening, at the very least, I encourage you to do it even just once a day. And there are various reasons why. First of all, I really do believe that by keeping this devotion, you will receive the grace of final perseverance. What is the grace of final perseverance except for the grace of eternal life, the grace of heaven? And that grace is specifically the person of Jesus Christ. Jesus is the ultimate gift for our salvation. Where did we receive such a grace? Where did we receive Jesus Christ? We received Jesus Christ through the Virgin Mary. So I personally believe that the grace of final perseverance will be most perfectly obtained through Mary's powerful intercession. Also, many people commit mortal sins because of lack of humility. What do I mean? Well, many people I know who struggle with impurity, for example, they think that, oh, by my own willpower alone, I will overcome my temptations to impurity. And that's simply not true. In my experience, overcoming temptation requires not only willpower, but reliance upon God. And by daily asking God, through Mary's powerful intercession, to help me to stay out of mortal sin, this is what? This is humility. And God honors humility. God wants us to be humble. God wants us to ask for assistance. And I believe that by persevering and asking for the grace to stay out of mortal sin, that through Mary's powerful intercession, she who was most pure, you will obtain this grace. Also, I think this devotion is beautiful because it serves as a daily reminder. Every day we start fresh. We have different goals and things that we have to do throughout the day. Well, by praying this every morning, it reminds us there's more to this life than the activities that we do throughout the day. It reminds us that there are consequences for our actions and that we must be on guard not to commit mortal sin, this most atrocious crime that would result in us having eternal damnation. So it grounds us, it reminds us daily. And finally, I like this devotion because it's catechetical. I work with young people, and sometimes if you ask them, is Jesus Christ God? They'll say, no, Jesus isn't God. Jesus is the Son of God. And of course, this is incorrect. Jesus is true God and true man. There are three divine persons, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And this devotion reinforces that, and it offers us an opportunity to catechize. I'd like to conclude this video by sharing with you how I personally combine the Seven Sorrows of Mary with the Three Hail Marys devotion. I'm in the car right now because that's where I pray this devotion. Now, to be honest, I have not always prayed these devotions, but when we moved 10 minutes away from my children's school, we no longer had time to pray the rosary on the way to school. So I wanted a devotion that I could pray on the way to school with my children and that we could complete. So when the kids get in the car, I say, okay, let's pray the seven sorrows of Mary, and we pray it for these intentions. I mention my intentions. The children, they mention their intentions. It's a beautiful moment for us to share with one another what we have on our minds and our hearts. Then we pray one Our Father, because I want this to be like a decade, so 7 + 3 = 10, so I add the Our Father. Then we pray the seven sorrows of Mary. When that is completed, I say, okay, let us now pray the three Hail Marys in honor and in thanksgiving to God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We pray in a special way that through Mary's powerful intercession, we may be free from all mortal sin this day, that at the hour of our death, we may be in the state of grace and we will receive the grace of final perseverance, that we can go to heaven. Oh, it's gonna be amazing. So we get excited about that. And because we have more time left over, because this is a very short devotion, it's an Our Father and 10 Hail Marys, we have time to pray a Glory Be, we have time to pray the St. Michael prayer, we pray the Guardian Angel prayer, and we also do a litany of the saints, and we take turns saying different saints that we want to pray for us. When we're done, my kids, they go to school and they have a wonderful day. That's how we do it in my family. Now, this isn't a devotion that I would be overly scrupulous about completing. A devotion that I am scrupulous about is the Most Holy Rosary. When somebody comes to me saying that they struggle with a particular temptation, a particular weakness, a particular vice, I always recommend the Rosary. If you're really serious about growing in holiness, pray the Rosary. St. Alphonsus Liguori himself would pray 3 rosaries a day. That being said, the 3 Hail Marys devotion is powerful and I do pray it. Now you might think, 3 Hail Marys, does it really make that big of a difference? It might not seem like a big difference in the moment in the day, but imagine if you prayed this every day for 46 years. I'm 34. If I prayed 3 Hail Marys for my salvation every day for 46 years, I'd be 80 years old. That would be over 50,000 Hail Marys that would be applied to you at the hour of your death for that special grace at that most important moment. That being said, I can't help but think, what if I prayed the rosary every day? Wow, let's say I prayed the rosary every day for 56 years. That would be more than 1,000,000 Hail Marys. Wow. So although I love the 3 Hail Marys devotion, I pray it every day, I can't help but acknowledge that there is a devotion better than the 3 Hail Marys devotion. And you all know what that devotion is, my friends. It's the Holy Rosary. Let's go ahead and end this video by praying the 3 Hail Marys devotion because it is a short devotion. Let's pray in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Blessed Virgin Mary, we ask you through your powerful intercession with God the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit to please help us not to commit any mortal sins this day. In a special way, Blessed Mother, I want to ask you for the grace of final perseverance for myself and for all of those people who support me. They pray for me. They subscribe to my videos. They watch my videos. They share my videos. Blessed Mother, it is my desire, it is my hope that we can all worship God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit for all of eternity together with you and with all the angels and saints in heaven. So let's pray in honor and in thanksgiving to God, the Father. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In honor and in thanksgiving to God, the Son, Jesus Christ, truly God and truly man. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In honor and in thanksgiving to God, the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And may all glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, as it is now, and ever shall be, a world without end. Amen. God bless you all. Thank you for watching.